What are you doing?
I'm walking.
You're supposed to be in bed, Sonny.
No. I'm going to rest on the sofa.
Sweetie.
Don't. I'm cool.
I'm just here in case you fall, in case you hurt yourself.
All right, watch. Just don't help me right now. Okay? All right, watch it.
Did I hurt you? I didn't hurt you.
See, no problem at all.
Did I hurt you?
No.
Why'd you wince?
No, I'm all right. That was a look of concentration.
Sonny, I'm trying to be a good nurse here.
Okay.
Means you gotta be a good patient.
I'm working on it.
There's nothing to work on. You just have to do it. You just have to sit here then all day on this couch and not do anything at all.
I don't know how.
I'll give you some couch potato lessons when I get back.
It'd be good for you to go back to work.
I just have one little baby appointment, but I could cancel if you want. I could stay here and I could make you some chicken soup.
I am fine. You go handle whatever you need to at work.
Okay. But I promise I'm going to come right back and I'm going to take care of you.
I'll be waiting.
Don't injure yourself.
I'm good.
Do yourself a favor and don't get up. I know from gunshot wounds they like a lot of rest.
Thanks for coming by.
Yeah. What can I do for you?
You hear anything about Sorrell?
Just that the grand jury indicted him and he disappeared.
No trace of him yet.
He didn't check his itinerary with me, if that's what you mean.
He still cooperate with the FBI occasionally?
Well, I wouldn't go so far as to say that.
Well, Alexis told me that they were interested in Xander's case after he spoke to you.
I might have mentioned that the kid was a good candidate for the witness protection program.
Well, Xander didn't agree because he ran and Sorrell's out there, too. If the FBI don't catch him soon, Xander Smith could be dead.
I got a couple old contacts at the FBI. Doesn't mean I work for them.
None of those contacts mentioned where they're looking for Sorrell?
Not to me.
You're in an interesting position, Roy. Alexis tells me you can testify against Sorrell, but you won't. You could ask the FBI where they're searching for Sorrell, but you don't want to do that either. You don't want to protect Sorrell. What's going on?
Now I know what Luke meant.
Oh, we're discussing Luke now?
Well, he told me how you can get come crunch time. You've been ambushed, so now everybody's loyalty is suspect, even mine. Okay. No. I'm not working for the FBI. I'm not protecting Sorrell. And I haven't double-crossed you. Not that I'm in a position to, anyway.
You went to the FBI about Xander?
Yes, I did. I didn't want the kid to get stuck between you and Sorrell. And lo and behold, what happens? He almost gets gunned down on the steps of the police station, no less. Because he trusted you.
True.
So what is that? You didn't realize how desperate Sorrell was? Or you just took a calculated risk and lost?
I haven't lost yet. I'm still alive. Sorrell's a fugitive.
Yeah. And this kid is stuck in the middle of it. He's smack dab in the middle. Bullseye on his face. I worked a case like this once. With a kid named Leo Bedford. He had enough evidence to bring down this major crime figure in Chicago the FBI wanted really bad. But the kid wouldn't cooperate. He wouldn't roll over. He was loyal.
I don't see the parallel, Roy.
Xander Smith is loyal to you now, Sonny. If it's true he ran, he'll be back. He'll testify against Sorrell because you want him to.
You know what your problem is, Roy?
Huh?
You don't know which side you're working for. You're not sure if you're a cop or a wise guy. It makes you hard to trust.
So don't trust me, Sonny. Are we done here?
Yeah.
You need to make sure you get Xander through this alive. If you don't, you know better than Sorrell.
I want to be the face of deception, Laura. Really, I do. And I'm hoping that you and Carly will choose me. But See, I'm wondering, Gia seems to think she has a real shot at this, and I...
Look, Elizabeth, you're my first choice, okay?
Okay, but see, that's what I mean. If I already sort of have the job, then it isn't exactly fair to Gia. I mean, she's really excited about this, and if she gets her hopes up and thinks she has a chance, then... Am I making any sense? Do you understand what I'm saying?
Yeah, I do. You don't want her to go through all of this for nothing, right? I know. I don't want to do that to her either. That's why Carly and I will not be making any final decisions until we have both looked at the test photos. Okay?
Okay. Not that I'm happy to have this competition, but I'm glad we're all clear.
You do have the edge, though. And I told Gia that.
Well, she hasn't mentioned anything.
I'm not surprised. At any rate, it will all be over soon, one way or the other, so don't worry.
Oh, I thought you were in Paris.
I just got back.
Oh. The first person you called was Elizabeth.
He's resting.
All right, I'll be quiet. Thanks, John. Thanks.
Sure.
Mike.
Hey, I'm not here. Go back to sleep.
I wasn't sleeping.
Then go back to resting.
Well, you do what?
Look, Carly doesn't cook, and you're supposed to stay off your feet, so I'm just going to whip up a vegetable frittata.
No, thanks.
But, Sonny, you got to eat. This will take 5 minutes, max.
Mike, I don't need any food, but... Maybe I wouldn't mind some company.
So, Happy New Year.
Win any money on the games?
I'm not betting these days. I'm too busy worrying about you. So how's my godson?
He went to the park with Leticia. If you want to go see him,
I came to see you.
I thought you came to cook.
Why don't you just admit that you're hungry, and I'll make you that frittata.
No offense, Mike, but your frittatas are not that good. Oh, I mean, it's not.
It's one of my best recipes.
The eggs should be lighter, and you should whisk them in a copper bowl.
That is for egg whites. For whole eggs, any kind of bowl will do the same.
Not with my frittatas.
Sonny, the secret is in the way you flip them in the pan.
Well, you only can say that because you don't use a copper bowl.
And maybe if we don't watch our step, we could end up in an argument over something as insignificant as a frittata.
No argument there.
I honestly didn't know if you were going to survive this.
I was hoping to see you here at the office, but if I hadn't, I would have called you to tell you that everything went very, very smoothly in France. In fact, once the French firm found out that we were definitely back in business, they were very quick to sign a new deal with us and give us all the essences we need at a fair price.
That easy, huh?
Mm-hmm. Well, they're not stupid, you know. They see a profit just like we do. There you go. Anyways, I wrapped it all up a day early.
So here you are.
Yeah, here I am. How's Sonny?
He's good. He's better. He came home from the hospital yesterday.
Oh, that's great. I'm so glad. Give him my best.
I will. What are you doing here?
Laura wanted to let me know the test shoot is this week.
Oh, now you know. Better hurry back to Kelly's because the lunch crowd will be in soon, huh?
Laura, thank you so much for everything. Glad you're back. Thanks. And I will see you both later.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Excuse me.
It's not necessary to be rude to her father.
What can I say? She just brings it out in me.
Look, if she's going to be our signature model, you're going to have...
If? Oh, that is a great big if.
You are going to have to find a way to get along with her.
Well, let me tell you something. You better keep an open mind about Gia. This has got to be a fair test shoot, you know, without you giving extra help to Elizabeth.
I'm not giving extra help to Elizabeth.
Fine. I just want to make sure everything's out in the open.
Oh, Miss Spencer. Hi. I thought I was only meeting with Carly.
Actually, Gia, I think your meeting with Carly is private since she set it up without informing me.
You were out of town.
Oh, right. Yeah, that must be it. Well, feel free to use my office while I check my messages at the reception area. I'd like to speak to you alone after.
Don't have to shut the door.
You know, if there's a problem, Carly, I can...
Everything is fine.
Well, my test shoot hasn't been canceled or anything.
No, we are still on. I only called you in because I wanted you to know that you're going to be great and you have exactly the right look for deception, so there's nothing to worry about, okay?
It's hard to believe you actually want me as a face of deception.
Gia, why else would I have chosen you?
To stick it to Elizabeth.
I have to admit, I'm not one of her biggest fans, but... The bottom line here is not about personal feelings. My husband is backing me on this company, and I am damn sure going to make sure that it's a success. You know, I'm putting everything I have into putting deception on the map.
Well, there are a lot of gorgeous models out there.
Gia, you're beautiful. You are a gorgeous girl. Your photos are going to come across with so many nuances. You're going to show innocence. And beauty, and vulnerability, and intelligence, and you're savvy, and you're romantic, and you just have exactly the right look. You're gonna make those products fly off the shelves.
Wow, I didn't realize you were actually counting on me like that.
You can do it, though, right?
You're right, I can, and I will come through for you, I promise.
Good. I'll call you later with the date and the time of the shoot.
I'm ready.
Okay. Laura said she wanted to talk to you, so I'm going to send her in.
Yeah, I don't think Laura exactly shares your confidence in me.
It doesn't matter. The photos are going to come across, and that's what counts, so just don't let her get to it. Okay.
It was close for a while there. But Carly never left your side. She would tell anyone who would listen that you were gonna live. She loves you a lot.
She's a pain most of the time. She almost killed me trying to get me dressed this morning. But she doesn't quit. I lived because of Carly. I couldn't leave her.
Finally, you listened to me.
You?
Yeah, I sat by your bed and I told you not to leave your family. So, I was right, wasn't I? Come on, come on, come on, you can say it just once.
You were right, Mike. Carly gave me something to live for. Maybe I should give her something in return.
Good while I was gone?
I was very good.
Yeah?
But I'm better now.
Me too. Missed you.
So what are you doing for the rest of the week?
Taking care of you.
Well, I assume that's not a 24-hour occupation.
Where are you going with this?
Well, you know, I got a little surprise in mind.
For me?
No, for Johnny. Of course for you.
What kind of surprise? What is it?
Oh, I'm not telling.
You have to tell.
tell me, Sonny. I hate surprises. Come on, what is it?
Stop. You're giving me stress.
Oh. I'll stop. When you tell me what it is.